Welcome to recrystallization, our first experiment. I will show you quickly what equipment you will be using. Some conical flasks, a rack of test tubes, a funnel, process clamps, a water bath and some ethanol. So we start off with our mixture, and what we want to do is we want to dissolve that in a little bit of cold solvent, in this case ethanol. As we can see, when we shake the test tube, the cold solvent doesn't dissolve it, which means we have to heat it up a little bit. Recrystallization is about using the minimum amount of hot solvent to dissolve your component and then separate it from an insoluble compound. So here we clamp it into a test tube holder. The water bath has around 100 degrees. We can use the steam above the bath. We shake it until one of the two components has dissolved. That might take some time. And in case not everything dissolves in the amount of solvent you have chosen at the boiling temperature of your solvent, you might want to add a little bit more. Do that in small increments. Again, heat it up to the boiling point of your solvent and see if it dissolves everything. Now, after that is the case, as you can see here, you are ready to separate the solution from the insoluble material. That process is called decantation and is depicted here. So here we have our solution and insoluble material, and we carefully run out the solution and make sure that the solid stays behind. You can see that here clearly. You have the solid in your test tube and the clear solution in your conical flask. What you want to do next is you want to crystallize the compound of your solution by letting it slowly cooling down. And in a very slow process, you might form crystals. Crystallization takes a long time, and in this movie it is sped up a little bit to show you how the crystals form. Sometimes no crystals form and you might want to cool your solution even with ice to get a lower temperature, or alternatively, as shown here on the right side, you might want to use a glass rod and stick it into your solution and scratch a little bit on the glass wall to induce crystallization. Here you could see some crystals that have been formed previously by scratching the glass rod at the glass wall and cooling solution down. You can see also a clear difference. When it's crystallizing very slowly, you end up with nice crystals. When you crystallize it fast with a rod and with some cooling down, you end up with some small crystals that are less nice. In the next video, we show you how to separate the crystals from the solution by filtration. What I have shown so far in this video was how to decant a solution from an insoluble material. Since that was a large amount, we used the large Büchner funnel that is depicted here right in the picture. If you do a recrystallization of your compounds, you might have smaller amounts to deal with, and then you want to use a smaller Büchner flask depicted here on the left with a smaller funnel, which is called Hirsch funnel, as you can see on the left as well.